Well, welcome everybody. It's a very special Fridays with Friends. I'm here live from Houston, Texas at an Intercontinental Hotel here in the Medical Center at the NMA Region 5 Conference. And I'm joined by a very special guest.
Thank you. So I'm Dr. Alysia Kemp. I'm an orthopedic oncologist here in Houston, Texas. And I was the leader of the student symposium today.
Well, wonderful. And you heard it right. Orthopedic oncologist, that means that's not only a subspecialty of surgery, but a subspecialty of that subspecialty. So color me very impressed. And as she mentioned, she helped organize this entire student symposium that I was able to attend today. And I was just so inspired by so many of the sessions y'all put on. And one thing I wanted her to kind of touch on for the entire vlogosphere is about leadership. They mentioned a lot of things about being a leader in your field at any stage of your training. And I just wanted to know what has been your experience in that call, and what is your advice for others?
Sure. So I think leadership is something that we think we have to be elderly or aged before we can be qualified to be a leader, and I think that that is 100% false. I think every day and every interaction you have an opportunity to be a leader. I think in my experience, I've really taken the knowledge that was passed on to me as a student, and it's been my passion to pass it on to other students because I want us to be our best selves when we arrive on the wards. And I think other students of different backgrounds receive that mentoring at home, but a lot of us don't come from two parents physician households, and so it was my passion in life to pass that on to the students that I mentor. And for me, being a leader just means showing up every day, leading by example, being what you want to see, the change that you want to see in the world. And so I really try to express that to the students in a way that I think is palatable and is culturally relevant, and so it's delivered in a way hopefully that my students can receive it.
Yeah, well, I have definitely received it. Thank you so much, because I think you're right. We feel like we aren't quite qualified yet to lead or to do leadership activities. So I appreciate that admonishment to go for it. You know, be present, be involved, be the change you wish to see. I love that quote, and I love even more when I see it embodied in role models such as yourself. Can just kind of to piggyback off of that as I wrap up, since I am entering into residency, a time that is famed to be very, very busy. For others in other professions who think that you're at the beginning stages of building your career and things are just crazily busy as you're trying to build up your profession and your professional experience, how would you recommend we fit in those leadership same things as you would encourage students to do?
So, number one, residency is very busy. No matter what specialty you choose, you will be busy and you will feel like you are pressured and never have enough time. So the first thing you have to be is organized. I wake up pretty much every morning, even Saturdays and Sundays, and I create a to-do list. So it's a little sticky note. I love being Mary Jane, so I got that from her. I create a little sticky note, and it's at least two or three things on that list that I want to check off every day. And it could be studying, it could be laundry, it could be anything. And so I check off those things, and then I, you know, also factor in time for myself. So I factor in time to go to the gym. I factor in time to cook. I factor in time to spend with my husband. I factor in time to walk our dog. So you just have to be really organized and prioritize the things that are important first. Create those safe spaces so that you get those done, and then you factor in time for other things that are not as important, you know, later on in the day. Another thing is that you will be faced with a lot of opportunities, and while you do want to say yes as often as you can, you have to learn also how to say no. There will be times when you'll be pulled in two different directions, and you have to learn how to decide what things are going to further you in your career and what things are going to be distracting and not take you to where you want to go. So that being said, there is time for fun, and I probably brunch a little bit more often than I need to brunch, but you know, I factor those things in, and if I've brunched four times this month, maybe I may not brunch a fifth time, but right. You know, I do factor in those things because that is something I love. So just have to prioritize, be organized, and then don't lose yourself in residency. I think the times that I see people fail is when they try to assimilate and they try to change who they are. I think you have to go into residency knowing that you want to come out the best version of yourself. And so that means you have to still be yourself at the end of it. So you just have to be in if you're a person who believes in God, stay in contact with your church, stay, you know, invested in yourself, and just, you know, you'll be the best version of you, but you'll still be you at the end of the day.
I love that. Okay. I love that. I just want to like snap my fingers, clap. Yes. Everything you just said was just so, it is really nourishing to my spirit to hear these words, you know, from someone who's been through it, who's gotten through it successfully. I think that and it's very manageable tips, you know, being organized is something that's so simple, yet it, you know, most of us don't do it as often as we should, making those to-do lists, being, you know, reasonable about getting just at least two or three of those things done, and being true to yourself. That's something that I'm just, I don't know, every time I hear it, it reminds me to do that. And I think it's just the easiest thing in the world is to be yourself, be you. And so to hear that that helps fit in those things that are important, and to be kind of discerning of what is important and what's not, I think it's just advice that we all can use. So thank you so much, Dr. Kemp, for this.
Welcome.
It's been so enriching for me. Hope it's been enriching for y'all. And here's
and
the last words.
Yep, anyone can contact me if you have any questions at LadyDoc2013. So LadyDoc2013@gmail.com.
And we will link that up to this blog post as well. So thank you so much. And this has been Jasmine on Finding a Better Way.